This is the SAP Developer News for January 23rd, 2025.
The annual SAP Developer Insight Survey is live now. This is the sixth annual running of the survey for us. If you've taken it before, you'll see many familiar questions, things that we use to track trends over time. There's also a deeper exploration this year of topics like generative AI for developers and also developer enablement. In the description section below, you're going to find two links. The first is actually a link to last year's report. If you haven't looked at that yet, I think you'll find the results interesting. The second link, of course, is to this year's survey. It will take about 12 to 15 minutes of your time to complete. The survey is going to be open for about 6 weeks. At the end of that time, we'll go off and analyze the data and produce a report that we'll share with you. So I look forward to seeing your comments at the point that we do that. In the meantime, dive into the links, explore it, and we appreciate your feedback. It's important because it helps us shape the programs that we use within the community for 2025. Thank you.
Good morning. Storm Ioane is on its way. It's already bitterly cold. It's starting to rain and the winds are gathering. But I've just got time before I go out on my run to tell you about the grassroots annual SAP Tech Conference of the Year. That is, of course, CodeConnect. It's happening again this year in the usual place, certainly en route, in Germany, near Waldorf. In the usual time of year, it's the first full week in July, and we have two usual suspect one-day conferences, the awesome recap and the amazing UI5 con. And CodeConnect is joined this year by a new conference, HANA Tech. So we're also planning to run a couple of code jams on the Monday, the first day of the CodeConnect week. So let us know if you're interested in those too. For those traveling from afar, there's also an early bird ticket application process. Anyway, all the links are in the description. I'm going to be there, and I hope to see you there too.
Hey, I wanted to tell you about the new release of the SAP Cloud SDK for AI. This is a great tool for JavaScript developers to be able to build your own custom AI orchestration services and interactive applications. In this new 1.6 release, we see the inclusion of image recognition in the orchestration service, as well as streaming capabilities in the orchestration client. So if you're a JavaScript developer looking to get started with SAP AI capabilities, be sure to check out this new release of the SAP Cloud SDK for AI.
SAP Build Process Automation is introducing a new type of process step, wait for an API call. The step lets you pause a process instance and then let an external system call an API to resume it. When you add this type of step to your process, you are creating a new trigger. But instead of this trigger creating a new process instance, it merely resumes an existing instance that had already been paused by the step. The idea is to allow process automation to integrate with external systems and let those systems take over part of the process and then signal back to the process instance that it has finished. It seems like it'll open up a world of possible integration scenarios with process automation. I've written a blog on how to use it step by step, and I will leave a link to the blog post in the description.
Hola, SAP developers. Did you know that there is a new interest group in SAP Community which focuses completely on the integration topic? This is our place to share and connect with a collaborative community of integration developers. Now, what are you waiting for? Go and join the new group. I'm including the link in the description.
I'd like to tell you about a new addition to the certification experience, particularly for SAP Build Low-Code, No-Code certification. SAP is adding a new hands-on, practical portion of the certification experience. This is a free learning course that comes with system access to allow you to execute exercises to get hands-on practical experience. This is part of a new effort by SAP to bring more practical capabilities and testing as part of the certification experience. So check out the links in the show notes for the addition to the certification, the particular certification that's involved, as well as the free experience learning journey that you can take to get ready for that certification.